Hi Raspberry Pi fans, here's a quick video showing the newest Raspberry Pi model, which was launched on the 15th of November 2018, the Raspberry Pi 3 Model A+. So let's get straight down to business. Here's the box it came in, very similar to previous packaging for the Raspberry Pi. Here's the A Plus itself, which you can see there. And as you see with this A model, it's very similar to the main model, which is the Pi 3 B Plus, except it's got this right hand side missing. So you can see the USB and Ethernet chip here is gone. The Ethernet port's gone, and there's now only one USB port rather than the four you had on the B+. This makes the A+ smaller, and it gives it a lower power consumption because it's got the sockets down here missing. So the main features of the A+ are pretty much the same as on the Pi 3 B+. It's still got the same Broadcom BCM2837 chipset in the center at the heart of the board. It's still 1.4 gigahertz and it's still quad core. It's got the same 40 pin header along the top. It's got the same Wi-Fi module here that does Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. It's got the same display connector on this left hand side. It's got the same camera connector here on over on the right hand side. 3.5mm jack with composite video stereo audio, and also the same full size HDMI port on the bottom, and for power, micro USB here. So effectively all of this board here is the same as on the B+, but just with that right hand side modified. So comparing the two boards in terms of dimensions, they're both 56mm from top to bottom. The B Plus is 85mm wide, whereas the A Plus is only 65mm wide, so there's basically about a 20mm difference on that right hand side. The B Plus is about 18mm high from the top of the board up to the top of these connectors. It does depend whether you measure the spiky metal bits sticking out the bottom, which can add a few millimeters. But on the A+, simply because those ports aren't there, it's quite a bit shallower. So it's probably about 6mm shallower. So let's compare the new A+ model with the old A+ model, which was released in 2014, which is this one here. This is the new one. They're practically the same. The only big difference is obviously the new one is faster and more powerful, and it has that wireless module in the top left hand corner with the Raspberry Pi logo on it. So this has got Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, which obviously this one didn't have. They're the same physically, they've got the same ports. All the ports are in the same place. Mounting holes are in the same place, so wherever you may have previously used one of these, you can almost certainly drop this in as a replacement. It might use up more power, you might have to take that into account, but they're basically the same. This one's just overall a better specification, but everything is physically in the same place. So although the A+ lacks some of the connectivity of its larger big brother, the B+, it's cheaper by about $10, so in the UK that equates to about £10. So this costs £24, but the B Plus generally costs more like £34. Obviously this is smaller in two dimensions, so left to right in this case about 20mm, and it's a lot shorter than the B Plus because it hasn't got that Ethernet port or USB port stacked up on the right hand side. It's not perfect for all projects, but if you can live without the Ethernet and those extra USB ports, then this is a good alternative. It's cheaper, smaller, lower power consumption. So if you can, you know, if you can cope with the lack of connectivity on the right hand side, then all those things are probably going to be better for your project. If you don't own a Pi, then my advice is to buy the B plus, just because that extra connectivity on the right hand side is just potentially more useful to you. So if you're thinking of buying your first Pi, get a B plus. However, if you've already got a B plus and you're just working on projects, then definitely get your hands on an A plus, because it's certainly going to be useful to you. So just pick one of these up from your favourite Pi retailer, or possibly stick it on your Christmas list and hope somebody buys it for you. So anyway, thanks for listening. Hope you found this video useful, and until the next time, goodbye.